Today is the 26th of July, 2020. I am the Preacher, and welcome to SWAT Live News. Today's installment of SWAT Live News. Local shop robbed. Masks in shops. Ants invade. Swole Saturday interview with Boris. Earlier in the week, a local business shared some footage of some desperate smack rats trying to get their fix. Anybody recognizes these feral creatures, please report them to the local authorities. This week's Good Cows once again goes out to Samuel Hutchison, who is raising money to help repair damaged cows to war memorials. The link can be found in the SWAT Live announcements on the page, which is advertised in the top left-hand corner of the screen. On Friday this past week, it has become a legal requirement to wear masks in shops. A local by the name of Cornelius had this to say on the matter.
I mean, come on, what's this all about, eh, from today? Look at this, eh? I look like one of those Kay's catalogue ads, you know, for underwear from 1972. Oh, sticking out here. What? Do we have to wear these in the shop? And I've just heard, it's me, I've just heard, okay, that the staff in the shop, they can't tackle you about it if you're going without a mask. Only the police. Now, just think of this, right? The staff see you walk in for a pint of milk and you're not wearing a mask. So they go to the phone. They pick the phone. They dial 999. Okay? Hello, emergency services. Which emergency service would you like, please? The police, please. Okay? They put you through. Hello, good morning, South Derbyshire Police. Can we help? What is your emergency? A man just walked into the Tesco Express in swaddling coat without a mask for some milk. Okay, madam. And where is he now? He's just paid at the self-checkout and he's getting his car and he's driving off. Oh, unbelievable. Good morning, South Derbyshire Police. What's your emergency? A man has walked into Tesco Express to buy a pint of milk, not wearing a mask. Now, yesterday it was safe to go in a shop not wearing a mask. But today the virus is finished. It's 3 weeks holiday and it's back on the prowl. Only in shops, mind. I just love it. I don't know. Stay cool, everybody. Love you. And don't forget, get that mask on.
Here at SWAT Live News, have recreated what the scenario could have been like as the clock turned midnight in 24 hour supermarkets.
Thank you.
Stars Wednesday, Swat Live News, heart giving a shout out to Hair by Kerry, mobile hairdresser. They are offering 20% discount to NHS workers. The locals have been crying about flying ants. Luckily for these locals, swarms only really occur for a short time once every year. And hopefully they have dried their eyes since the great swarm of 2020. This Fitness Thursday, we at Swat Live News are giving a shout out to Lindsay Marie Page's MetaFit class. For those who want to beat down some of their lockdown lumber. The local authorities have once again stumbled upon a cannabis farm. La da 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 la da da la 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 la. We put it to a vote on the Swat Live page, asking if cannabis should be legalized under the same terms as alcohol usage. And these were the results.
Just doing my workout. Tuesday's arms and back. Oh, it's a deep burn. Oh, it's so deep. Oh, I could barely lift my right arm because I did so many. I'm just going to grab this shirt if you don't mind. Just watch out for the guns. They'll get you.
Yesterday, gym goers were as happy as pub goers were on Super Saturday. As yesterday, we celebrated Swole Saturday with many people, including yours truly, having the opportunity to lift weights that matter for the first time since the gyms had closed.
Dude, you're ripped. Thank you.
For pubs, clubs, events, and activities, Swat Live News would like to give a shout out to Micro Brew Radio.
Hello, Foxy Boris. That's make my excuses for looking a bit of a scruff. Even the dog's getting a bit bored of waiting for me to get myself together.
This is a great platform for local artists who perform their own original material. This week, the preacher called up with Boris, and we had this to say.
Hey, Foxy, Boris here. I'm just looking back on the last year. It's been exactly 1 year since I was made Prime Minister, and I've not been going to confession, so that's something that I wanted to speak to you about. You're the local preacher, I believe.
That's right, my child. I am the preacher, and you have been a very bad boy, Foxy Boris.
Well, the whole thing was that, Theresa May, there was a question mark as to how long she, would be the Prime Minister. Theresa may not have been Prime Minister much longer, so obviously someone had to step into the role. I was being a bit ambitious, I suppose, thinking that I could, do it. And, obviously I have been doing it. There wasn't anybody better, that was qualified, I suppose. But, Theresa May was no longer, going to be in the role. So there was obviously the Brexit situation, which was a bit of a problem as well. I'm going to blame Cameron. It's not in my nature, obviously, to blame people. What do you say about that?
My child, ambition is a sin. And even though Cameron dealt with the situation improperly just to get votes, my child, believe to begin with? How can you say this is entirely David Cameron's fault?
Well, obviously, you know, I saw enlightenment, like yourselves. You know, we sort of change our minds of things when we see the light at the end of the tunnel. And looking back, as you do with a mirror on the old push bike, as I do myself, if you actually look back, it's rather dangerous. So you have to use a mirror and use your, you know, like common sense. There was a bit of a bumpy road along the way with all the potholes, etc. But I managed to avoid the cracks in the road, like Corbyn. And you know, and use the appropriate hand signals, but there are hand signals, of course, that you can't use. That would be a little bit rude, especially on this sort of family program. But there is a few spats that me and the missus had as well along the way. But that was sorted out. We made a baby Boris. That was sort of the result of that. And you know, but just as long as he doesn't spill wine on the sofa, I think everything is going to be, you know, hunky dory. And that's an album by David Bowie, actually, so I might get in trouble for saying that.
My child, do you confess that in your time as Prime Minister that you have sinned the people of this country?
Well, you know, the whole thing is it's 1 year today that, you know, I've been Prime Minister. You know, I'm still here, so I'm going to have a celebratory drink. I'm going to, you know, drink my bottle of Corona, as you can see, and you know, obviously, you know, I'm not going to drink it because I'm, you know, you're the preacher and I'm not going to drink it in your presence. Well, I've actually left the top on as well, as you can see. But, you know, will you forgive me?
My child, the preacher forgives that you are not drinking a capped bottle of Corona.
Yes, there are double standards there, and hopefully that'll get edited out of the video. Do you think I should come to confession a little bit more? You know, it's been a year, and are you going to forgive me?
But, child, you should definitely come to confession more, and maybe one day your preacher will forgive you for all the sins you have committed against the people, against your preacher of this country of ours.
Okay, thank you very much. And I'm going to hide in the fridge now, so I'll see you next time.
Bacha, farewell.
That's all this week from SWAD Live News. Until next time, I hope you all have an awesome week.